Hey everybody, what's going on? Your host Lovely Cheese Pizza here. Welcome back to Let's Play Some More Grand Theft Auto 5. As we're still on that construction site, amazingly avoiding all of the possibilities of things going wrong as we were running away from the cops, and we just came here and they just totally gave up. It's not like we're like super out of the way. We're still kind of right in the middle of things, but hey, I'll take it. I will totally take this outcome here. So this is what we're dealing with now. We're in kind of a strange situation, because what we could do, could see if there's any missions for Franklin, which I don't believe that there are any right now. Michael's got a couple, but I really want to go over to Trevor and see what he's got going on, because we were still right in the, we were deep in the heart of Texas of trying to get those celebrity trash items all figured out, and so I really want to... why am I not surprised that that's where we find this man? And he's all drunk and hungover. Oh boy. Come on, Trevor. I mean, I know it's really, really against protocol to have you operate a motor vehicle in such a state, but you know what? I feel like you're one of those weird functional drunks. That is strangely better at doing everything when you're in a compromised position. So, do we still have the ability? Yes, we do. They're still right over here. So with that, I say we target one of these, and let's go check it out. I've been thinking about these things for like a couple of days now. I really want to know what these other items were. I really had a lot of fun getting the first two parts of that puzzle. They were fucking awesome. Chasing down the dog, and then I don't remember what the hell the other one was. It was so much fun, I can't even remember what it was. But I remember them being pretty comical. Really wish that I hadn't gone straight up the road to go to Michael's place and, you know, triggered that whole thing. But that mission was fun as shit, too. I loved it. Oh, good. Brad, no. It must be an imposter. Oh, shit. Okay. Hi, T. It's Brad from prison. No. It must be an imposter or something. He's dead. I saw pictures of his funeral. I know. Why don't you come out here and visit me? Oh, great. Oh, I can't wait to go visit Brad. That's going to be a real doozy. I can't wait to explain that whole story to him. Be like, hey, so everything you thought about him being dead, yeah, he's totally not dead. His hot bitch wife is still in the picture. He's got some kids now that are total assholes and sluts and other things. Oh, it's totally him, all right. He just decided to make his name Michael of Santa. Oh, good old Jimmy. Give me what you got. Hey, Uncle T, it's Jizzle. Jimmy D to the motherfucking S. So glad you are back. My dad has been acting like a wacko biatch recently, all angry and shizzle. Calm him the fuck down. Let's hang out sometime. I smoke a lot of weed now. Maybe you could take me drinking or something. I mean, that is definitely something that you would say to the cool uncle. My dad fucking sucks, but you're not. You're pretty awesome. So hey, let's totally subvert everything that my dad ever wanted to keep me in check with. Okay, God, everybody is just trying to hit him up right now. Big Bad Ron T, how's Los Santos? We miss you. We really miss you. Listen, there's all kinds of crazy sniffing about. No one is happy, and it's hard for me to do my job as acting CEO of the business. I think you should come back and help me and stay here forever, like we discussed. I'm worried the lizard people will eat you in Los Santos. They are there. The Lost seem to be in a lot of trouble since you paid them your last visit. The O'Neills also seem to have disappeared off the face of the earth. Abducted, I hope, but I reckon they'll surface again. Some Chinese fellows were seen sniffing about, asking after you in town. I reckon them guys that deal fell through with, but I ain't confirmed it yet. Either way, I miss you. Your CEO acting, Ron. All right, what do we got here? I see that we kind of stumbled upon the right spot here. There's got to be something good. Enter the club and find Willie. Okay. Boy, I can't wait to figure out what kind of club this is. Is that Mario over there? Oh, Space Monkey 3D, yes, an old Mario in space. No
mind if I do?
Oh, I don't think anybody's going to mind until you show up in there. Love Fist, those fucking guys. I forgot about these fools. Oh, Jesus.
Hey, who the fuck are you?
Don't worry about it.
His dentist.
Well, he's still downstairs chatting up some bird, man.
Whoa, his dentist comes to him? That is so cool.
Oh, yes. I'm going to fix all those cavities up in his face. All right, well, let's see what we have here. I got a regular teeth cleaning coming for ya. Oh, I've got an autograph for ya. You wanna have an autograph? I'll give you an autograph. Yeah. There we go. No, he's coming back up for more. Nope, that'll do him in. And now, oh shit. Okay, well, this is a real problem. Man, they called the cops fast. It's like they had that thing on speed dial ready to go. Okay, well, let's just grab one of these really nice cars. Or not.
Work is done here.
Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. We've got the answer. We've got the answer. Nothing quite like jumping into a nightclub and beating up the lead dude of Love Fist. I totally forgot about that from our good old days in Vice City. Those were good times. Alright, what are we driving a Tesla right now? That's kind of what that emblem looks like on the car. Oh boy. Did that just... I'm pretty sure that cologne advert just said, smell like a biatch. Don't get me wrong, I love wearing cologne as much as the next guy, but I don't think that I'd like to smell like a biatch. That just doesn't really sound like a very endearing thing. Ah. Come on. Come on, buddy, you gotta get rolling here. You got the fuzz hot on your tail. Oh, really tight thing that happened to me the other day. So, I don't know how, I mean, for some of you guys, you may not remember this story because I talked about it somewhere else, but, so I had the whole issue, with when I bought my first car, I got that really, really awesome, blue 2008 Nissan Altima that ended up going, you know, fucking belly up on me. The thing ended up being an absolute lemon above all lemons in the world. And I was really, really bummed, man. I didn't want to have to get rid of that car, but, you know, circumstances, you know, were circumstances, and, you know, you do what you have to do. But I had, and, like, when they got rid of it, they never told me what they did with it. Like, they never told me, you know, where it is that they, like, sent it off to, or whatever the situation may be. And, I was out driving, with my fiance the other day. We were going to get some Sonic because, you know, limeades are... our God serum. Oh, this is good. I think we shook him. I think we finally shook him. And we pull up to the stoplight, and there's like a little car lot that was like just a little bit up the road. And I saw. Oh, here we go. What's Niggle got to say?
Guess what? You crazy English fruitcake.
Oh, I'm dreadful at guessing. Aren't I, Mrs. Thornhill? No, she can't hear me. She's washing out a nappy from Samantha Muldoon's dustbin.
Yeah, one gold tooth, courtesy of Love Fist, complete with complimentary DNA.
Marvelous, marvelous. Oh, Jock, I knew you wouldn't let us down.
Toodaloo.
I wonder if Samantha Muldoon is related to Squire Muldoon from Rugrats. Okay, so we've got to get one more piece of the goods here. Wherever could it be? Or do we have them all? No, we can't have them all. There was still one more left, supposedly, on this whole thing. Well, that sucks. Well, what the fuck, man? That's a serious bummer. We had four pieces. And now there's not. All right, well, I mean, whatever. I guess we've got a Trevor thing to do here. If I can latch on... Well, you know what? We're just going to go to the safe house. I can't seem to latch onto that thing, so it's whatever. But yeah, so we pull up to the stoplight, and we see this little car lot up there, and I see a blue Altima sitting in the lot, and I was like, that looks kind of familiar. I was like, there's no way that's my old Altima, is it? I mean, that thing couldn't even drive. There's no way they got this thing sitting in a lot right now, and I'm sitting there kind of studying it. From the passenger seat, I was like, there's no way. And I'm sitting there looking at it, I was like, no, that can't be it. Like, the front end doesn't look quite right. I was like, there's just, I don't think that's it. I don't think that's it. She's like, are you sure? Because it really looks like it to me. I was like, no, there's something about the front end that doesn't seem right. And we start, you know, we start driving and we kind of pull up right next to it. And it totally fucking was. It was the exact same car. It even had, like, all the little holes in the front end from where, you know, the people took out the front license plate. And I was like, oh my god, it really is! It's really my Altima! What in the hell is it doing in this lot? That car was not drivable. Unless, of course, you know, the possibility that they were able to fix whatever the electrical issue was in there. But the funnier thing about the lot that it was sitting at is that was a car lot that sells all the cars as is. So, you know, you could get some real seedy looking things coming out of that, which sounds like that's the case, because I definitely, when I saw it, I sent a text to my friend that worked at the dealership that I, oh god. Okay, well, that's a thing. But he worked at the dealership that I got my Jetta from, and he was also the one that sold me the Altima. And I was like, dude, you'll never believe what just happened. He's like, what? I was like, I just drove by this dealership and I saw my fucking Altima there. He's like, no way, you're kidding. He's like, what dealer was it at? And I was like, well, it was this one on the corner of, Lancaster and State. And he was like, oh no. He's like, not that one. You gotta be kidding.
Trevor is a what?
Trevor is a good guy. He's got family. I got kid, ain't he, Floyd?
That's it, right. Yes, Trevor. but the thing is, I ain't been with that many women. I don't find it easy. And Deborah, I mean, we're getting married, so.
Well, that's beautiful.
But I'm scared that she's going to leave me. I mean, this is her place. And the fornicating? There's Mr. Raspberry Jam.
Whoa.
Mr. Whoa. Raspberry Jam?
Mr. Raspberry Jam. He died a noble death, bringing great joy to a lonely man.
I see you get many cream pies in the eye there, buddy.
Some girls laugh when they look at it.
Show me.
Show me!
He totally would. He totally would. Oh, God. Okay.
Mine ain't nothing special, but this boy gets the job done. All right? Now, Wade here says that you work at the docks.
Yeah. Why is he having this conversation with his pants off?
Put your Johnson away, sir.
Oh, dude, I just saw his balls dangling. What the hell? this game doesn't pull any punches. Oh, no. Oh, man, I would have had at least one gratuitous boob shot before we had to see Trevor's balls and freaking disgusting junk dangling around. Oh, my God.
Let's get you, Wade, and that little tormentor down there to put these on.
I have never heard of a man's penis ever referred to as a tormentor before.
Gentlemen, the gateway to America awaits.
R.I.P. Mr. Raspberry Jam.
Man at the port of L.S. I'm going to send you some information. I need you on point to help plan things.
I got it. I really miss.
He's like, yeah, I know the whole miss me thing. Like, look, man, I'm dressing up as a construction guy right now. I'm going to be holding out the old markers for a while, so I don't need to hear any of your bullshit about how you miss me and how the lizard men are coming to get you. I get it. You've definitely been to truthism.com. You know all about what's going on. But keep it to yourself for a little while.
Be more exact in your question.
That is beyond annoying.
In your question, sir.
We're looking for something to steal. Something to steal.
Sir.
It's so funny to me how they'll stop dialogue when we get in a wreck and then just totally resume it like nothing ever happened. Oh my god.
I'll do my utmost to assist you in finding it.
Here's the problem. I don't know what I want. It's a bit, well, like pornography or a perfect turd. I can't quite describe it, but I'll know it when I see it.
You ain't aiding my comprehension.
All right. Well, how's this? Two. $236 billion worth of cargo came through the port of Los Santos last year.
He's real good with numbers.
I don't want to hijack a truck full of pineapples, Floyd. You need to give us the inside track.
I want to hijack a truck full of raspberry jam in honor of your fallen comrade.
They certainly don't put price tags on them.
That just said, fill your pork hole. That's a fantastic advert.
Anything that might indicate something?
Love froth? Oh, that's gross. That's disgusting. I never want to hear any type of anything, especially an allegory for jizz being called love froth. Oh, it should not be bubbly and frothy. That just makes it seem like it's diseased.
So there's a private militia in the port. What are they guarding?
This one freighter? I guess now that you mention it, it ain't quite right.
A freighter. Perfect. Can I get on board?
No, no. They won't let you anywhere near it. They're kind of assholes about it, actually.
Go park and get the dispatch.
Yep, will do.
Go park and get the dispatch.
Who are these three crazy characters coming in their fucking off-road truck to work?
This can go real wrong real quick.
And it probably will, because it just takes any one of them to realize that they've never seen any of us before. All right, well, let's go follow Floyd.
You gonna take me to see this freighter?
Yeah, it's over here.
You ever got helicopters coming in and out of here? You know, those big sky crane things that could pick up a whole container?
Now, this is restricted airspace. They won't let anything out of here without clearance. Shoot it down if they have to.
So how's a man in a hurry supposed to get in and out of this place?
Well, we got a port that stretched to 50 feet.
Now, what's the Coast Guard response like?
Well, they got cutters, 45-foot response vessels, air support. You're not gonna move much faster than them, especially if you're carrying something.
Maybe I'll have to saddle you up and ride you across the Miriam Turner overpass.
I just said they have the water surface real covered.
Okay.
That is the freighter I told you about.
What do you think they got on it?
We just stevedored.
Oh, they got plenty of Bilgeco and Jetsam things, of course.
But these are marked military. Government.
Anything weird about that?
The government stuff is hot freight. Pulls up, goes right through.
It's just full of Philly cheesesteaks. I don't know why they put them in there, but they just are. They're not even wrapped up. They're just loose Philly cheesesteak sandwiches. I don't understand what's going on with it.
The guys at 2 o'clock. They're giving Forrest a hard time, all right.
Yeah, they just pushed that guy over and knocked him out.
You. We need two guys on the handler. A couple of containers and Baby got to be brought up to F. That ain't a question. Get on it.
All right, Forrest, I got it. Okay, so where am I going to be? Am I driving the bad boy, or...
Driving, I'll spot.
All right, fair enough. I would much rather be driving in this situation. I think the last thing that I want to be doing is handling that fucking thing.
How about I run that prick over in this thing?
I thought you wanted to scope the place. We don't get the containers, they're going to check your card.
Why wouldn't they be checking my card now?
You're always nervous. Relax.
Seems weird they just kind of let me waltz in here just because I had a vest on. When I could have, you could have picked up one of those vests at like the Halloween store. You're like, oh, you really look the part today, gentlemen. How'd you get out there and go handle some extremely heavy freight for no reason whatsoever? Okay, so these definitely seem to be the containers that they were looking for.
Those are the containers in Bay B.
Okay. Gotta figure out how to do this. I have a feeling this has all the makings of being an extremely upsetting... Here we go. I'm gonna say, this has all the makings of being an extremely upsetting mission to do. Just because it looks like it's a very precise thing.
That's it.
There we
now
go.
We got to bring it over to Bay F.
I know why they call them handlers, because they handle like a dream.
This ain't a toy, sir. It's heavy machinery.
Thank fuck I'm high as a kite.
You should not be operating this vehicle while under the influence.
I'll operate you under the influence if you're not careful.
Like, you don't understand. You don't understand, Floyd. I actually cannot function without it. I'm what you call one of them functional high, drunk, and loaded on drug type of people. That's just the way my body operates. Okay, so let's put this thing in good old lucky number 13.
There it is. Now I guess we gotta get the other one.
Yes, let's do that.
I'm gonna need a better view of that freighter.
I'm sorry, but this is as close as you going to get.
Nah. I need to take some pictures. Send them to my guy, Ron. I'll need a proper view.
There's the cranes, but...
Cranes! Perfect!
Oh, shoot.
What? What? Why was his cover blown? What the hell happened? What the fuck? What did I do wrong there?
Run that prick over in this thing.
I thought you wanted to scope the place. We don't get the containers, they're gonna check your card.
What the hell? I was doing my job. Why did they... What happened? I don't understand. I was doing everything by the book.
He'll be fine. Boy's on a waste clearance crew. He's never happened when he's neck deep in shit.
It's those containers. Bay B.
Dude, that was hot horse shit. That was so... Like, I don't understand what happened there. That was such a bizarre turn of events.
Now. Okay, we got it. Let's take her down to Bay F.
I know why they call them handlers. Because they handle like a dream.
This ain't a toy, sir. It's heavy machinery.
Thank fuck I'm high as a kite.
You should not be operating this vehicle while under the influence.
I'll operate you under the influence if you're not careful.
Okay, so we're gonna put this thing into 14 instead.
Happy? Now I'll get the other one for you. Me, anyway. I'm gonna need a better view of that freighter.
I'm sorry, but this is as close as you going to get.
Nah. I need to take some pictures. Send them to my guy, Ron.
Okay, this better not shit out on me again. I'm just going to get the... Oh, no.
Oh, shoot.
What? Is that the guy that was going to, like, blow my cover? Is that what's going on? Maybe I just need to, like, wait a minute. Wait for him to go away. I'm very confused. Like, I'm just gonna go over here and try to get my job done. Hopefully this guy doesn't totally blow everything for me. I'm just trying to help. I mean, I'm doing this job for free right now. I'm not even getting paid, you know, the union minimum here. I'm just trying to be a man to... help in a time of need.
Now you're paid brain surgeon bucks to push an oversized shopping cart.
I did not fellatiate no one to get this job. There was old friends with the...
With the say no more. You didn't fellate no one, but darling Debbie probably did. She probably enjoyed it.
Probably. She probably, like, laid on the bed and pulled her butt apart and everything just so a guy could poop inside of her own ass. Hey, people are into that. I'm not saying that it was right or wrong. I'm just saying that's what happens with people sometimes.
Okay, it's up to the top of the crane for me.
Okay, we gotta get to the top of the old big guy here. So let's just go take this thing for a spin. Where is this crane? Okay. Away we go. Hey, don't mind me, guys. I'm just a guy that's not supposed to be here. I'm gonna go take a look on what's atop your highest piece of machinery that you have, if that's perfectly okay with you. Alright, well, let's go check this out. I can tell you right away, this would not be something that I would be down with doing. I have such a nasty fear of heights. Like, this doesn't even seem like it'd be that bad, but for me, like, being on a high surface like this.
There ain't time to admire the view. I've been waiting on a crane driver nearly an hour.
Yeah, I'll bet you have.
Permitted to drive cranes, buddy.
Hey, you need me to get your union rep up here right now? Sooner you get in the cab, sooner we can get out of here.
This is on you.
Come up onto this catwalk, then go down the ladder and into the cabin.
Dude, come on, man. I'm just trying to take some pictures while I'm up here. I don't need to do all this other shit. Okay, where's this ladder that he's talking about? Oh, it's definitely over there. Okay. All right, I got you. I see what you want. But yeah, dude, this would not work out for me at all. I have such a horrible fear of this stuff. What the hell? Where's this ladder that he's talking about? I don't see what the fuck he's talking about at all. Ladder to get... He said come up on this catwalk and then take the ladder to get down into the cabin? Where the fuck is that? I don't see it at all. I am very confused. Oh, it's over there. Okay, I'm stupid. All right. No criticism. Oh, God, okay. Whew. That could have been bad. Here we go. This is what Papa was looking for. Get down the ladder, Trevor. I know you're high and you're drunk, but God, get down the thing. There we go. Yeah, it's like sitting in one of those motorized wheelchairs.
What do I do?
Load the containers onto the... Okay. This is not... Dude, this is not a great angle.
Line up the cabin over the container. The lights on the bottom of the spreader will help you position it. Looks like you're in line.
Okay.
You're in position, so drop the spreader down and secure the load.
Oh, I'll show you how to secure a load, all right.
Looks good to me. Grab onto it. It's hooked up, so lift it high enough to clear that container stack and move it to the other end. We need to go to...
Oh, God, nope. You gotta go up. There we go.
We ain't there yet.
Okay. Here we go. I unfortunately did not hear... where he said to take this thing. I'm hoping that it's just straight down over here. If not, this is gonna be a total waste of time. Oh, here we go. Okay, we're good. We are definitely good. I really don't like this angle at all.
Set it down gentle. Bring the container down over the truck's frame.
I'm working on it. Don't you worry about me. Oh boy, that doesn't seem right. Nope, back up, come on. Bingo!
All that freight. And you said you wasn't qualified. Go back up to the other end and start again.
I'm definitely not qualified for this job. Did you see how nasty that was at the end? I was basically scraping that thing all the way down. I'll take it though. Oh, we can change view. Oh, that is so much better. Holy shit. Why are they just now telling me this? That would have been like 900 times better. Oh, dude, this is so much better in literally every way. Holy fucking yes. Okay, and then we're going up and we're going back. Oh my god, this is so much better. This is okay, should probably pick it up a little further than that. There we go. Okay, alright, no, let's just keep it this way. For god's sakes, it's getting a little nasty out there. All this just so I can take some pictures. For god's sakes. For a minute I thought we were going to have like this crazy stacking job to do. Where it was going to be like a crazy ass game of Tetris. But, you know, I'll totally take this, though. Nope. Okay, go this way a little bit. Nope. All the way down. Come on. Which one of these is gonna let me secure the load? There we go.
All right, you're done. Break time.
and your break time is 3 hours. You come on the clock, you do two moving jobs, and you take a break for 3 hours. All right, get to the vantage point at the end of the catwalk. Sounds good to me. Oh, we're right in front of that freighter too. Sick. The SS Bulker. Use the camera phone to take pictures of the boat. Let's go. This will be the first time that we've actually gotten to do this. All right. Photograph the front of the ship. Sounds good. Take the deal. Look at that. Take a photo of a guard on board the ship. Sounds good. I can do that. Aha, there he is. Take a long shot of the back of the ship. Oh, look at all those bilgecos and jet sams. But they do definitely preach safety first. Send these bad boys to good old Ronski. What do you have to say for yourself, Ron? Send the crane to the dock's floor. Photos received, boss. Okay, here we go. Photos received, boss. I'll turn up some info and get back to you when I have something. Sounds good. Job well done, my friend. Let's get the hell out of here. This ended up being a slightly longer episode than I was planning on, but I will take it. All right, here we go. Okay. I was afraid I was going to run right off of that thing and get myself a couple of snapped legs, maybe a busted clavicle, and maybe a little bit of brain leakage on the ground. Certainly a plausible... No, go back the other way. What are you doing? Why are you, like, doing this weird, like, looping off of the ladder thing? Just let me get the hell off of this thing. There we go. Look at that. Completed like a real man.
I can take you over to the warehouse. We can use the big rig.
Big rigs. All right, guys. Well, you know what? We're going to stop right here. This thing's already gone on a pretty long way as I see it. So when we come back on the next installment of Let's Play Grand Theft Auto 5, we're going to finish up this mission that's taking about 72 years, and we'll see where that takes us. We'll probably... If it doesn't open up any more missions for Trevor, we'll jump over to either Franklin or Michael and see what's going on with them. So until then, my friends, this is your host, Lovely Cheese Pizza, saying thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Take it easy, everybody. Bye.